Alright, so it's Tuesday morning. We're out here doing a little service to the track cutter today. So we're gonna get some video of that. And the rest of the job's working as normal. It's a windy day. Hopefully it doesn't rain. I don't think it's supposed to. Who knows anymore with our weather. But y'all come along with us. As long as the John Deere people don't mind, we're gonna do some video and then I'm working on the track cutter today. Hang around. So we got the John Deere opened up. You can see there's lots of access. Big old motor in that thing. That's a horse. Anyway, we're changing swing drive motor, gear oil, changing planetary gear oil, changing hydraulic oil, changing hydraulic filters, planetary, maybe I've already said that, planetary drive motor gear oil. We got lots of stuff we're doing today to it, so I'll just hang out and keep watching. We'll maybe we can get some good video here. I'm doing some cool stuff in a minute. What is up, everyone? Okay, so it's now Wednesday morning. I got volunteered for a school function for my kids yesterday. Didn't get, I don't know what y'all have seen so far. To this point, I haven't even got to look at the video of what I got yesterday, but it was not very much of the service on the A53. And I apologize for that, but sometimes that's just how it goes. So right now, I'm trying to crawl up in this 853, get her busted off for the day. Have a big day today. We have lots of big foresters coming out. We have a lot of foresters coming out today. They're doing some kind of timber tour for my job, so that's pretty cool. I have a bunch of landowners and investors from a timber management company on hand. I don't know if they're gonna let me film any of that or not. Anyway, who knows what today will hold. Definitely got to get back on track with the videos. As of right now, I haven't posted a video in 2 days, and that's not what I really want to be doing. So we'll try and get some video today and try and get something set up. Hopefully, is it today's Wednesday? Hopefully Thursday we'll have a good video back ready for everyone to watch. So try and get things a little bit back to normal and on track around here. Anyway, y'all hang around. We'll be back. think I have a mic cable crap out on me right there, so I had to swap. Go back to the internal mic on the camera itself. Also being shot on the new Sony camera that I have, so I'm not sure if it looks the same as it does on this little screen right here or what. Almost looks like it's too dark, so it's gonna take a couple of videos of getting used to this thing before I get the settings figured out where they need to be. Kind of have an idea of how far away from the road the loader needs to be. Set the other one up properly. And going now. Got the first couple of buckets helium. Loading the truck over there across the road. I love this camera. It's like I'm right on top of the stuff. It's so cool. Anyway, we'll just sit here for a minute. Kind of watch the 234 run. I'm waiting on the rubber tire to get a down road cut. The least amount of tracking on the woods, the most amount of time you can spend tracking on bare ground with one of these track cutters, you'll come out better in the long run, because that wood just twists your tracks and stuff and wears them out quickly. You can stay on flat ground, when I say flat, if you can just stay on the bare ground, you come out way better in the long run. Sitting here playing a dummy marker loader for the other loader. He's still over there loading trucks. Barely see him through my door there. So I'm kind of sitting here as a placeholder right now, letting the other loader get a good idea where he needs to be placing his wood and stuff. Kind of helps him get started. So that's what I'm doing right now.
About 3,000.
interesting week so far. Today is Wednesday. We had a group of investors come by with our timber management company looking at the land. They're the investors for the property that we own, or that we're cutting, that they own, that we're cutting on. And they come by checking us out. Didn't get no video or anything of those guys. I told them about the channel and they thought it was a cool thing, but I didn't, you know, let them, I didn't get any video or anything with them. So. They're done loading that truck. Matt's fixing to get down and trim him. Looks like they still got probably about a quarter of a load over there, which we'll skid it.
961-546-31.33.
Yeah, it's about a quarter of a load still laying over. Might be closer to a half. Anyway, we'll skid it over here. Got the 748 over there running over the tops and that big pile I built for the loader as I cut the deck out. The little hedge bushes are horrible over here too. The foresters and the investors that were here earlier actually give a scientific name for what we call the Yopon bush, which is what you just saw him pull out, and I can't remember it. It was some big old long name. The forester pointed it out to the investor, called the big old scientific name for it, and I was like, you mean Yopon? And he was like, yeah, Yopon. So, a little bit of a funny moment there. The limbs on that mess. You watch, he's got a full bucket there. Tigercat probably hold another piece, but that's 8 pieces. 2, 4, 6, yep, 8 pieces. He just delimbed 8 pieces of wood, processed, fully processed, 8 pieces of wood in about 30 seconds. Well, somebody scroll back through the video. Tell me how many seconds that was that took to process that. I bet it wasn't 30 seconds. Anybody that runs one of these loaders and runs it in pine lob lolly knows you cannot process 8 pieces of wood in 30 seconds. With that pull through like he just did with the chambers. Those limbs are like rubber too. A lot of this stuff here come off the road. So you got a roadside over there, and then you got a roadside kind of right here. So you have a double whammy on the roadside stuff. Roadsides can be, the limbs just grow twice as bad on a tree because there's so much extra sunlight hitting the tree. The limbs just don't prune off the tree as it grows. They stay there and they stay green. To all the new subscribers that have joined the channel, we appreciate you here. We appreciate the view and your subscription and everything like that. If you haven't looked back to any of our videos, to learn some of the other stuff about us. We are based out of South Louisiana, Southwest Louisiana. Been in business this December. Our company will have been in business for 20 years. This is job number two of the two jobs that we have. Job number one is my dad's job. This is a little bit smaller job. We have the same amount of equipment on this job as my dad's job. We have two loaders, two skidders, two cutters. We only fully run four pieces of equipment at all times. One skidder is full-time, one loader is full-time, or two loaders are full-time, and then one cutter is full-time. I have a fifth man out here that hops around and helps cut a little, and he helps skid a little, just kind of wherever we need the slack picked up. We have a 748 John Deere skidder, a 620E Tigercat skidder. We have an 853M track feller buncher, which is what I am on right here. And it is equipped with the FR50 head. You can see there. Big old prototype pulpwood head from John Deere. We have a 718E rubber tire cutter that, like I said, just kind of helps fill in here, there, and yonder. And I have two Tigercat loaders. They're both 234 models. One is a B, one is the original 234. One loader has 20,000 hours on it. The other loader, this one right here, I think it has like 2,000 hours on it now. We purchased it last year when we started this job, the same way we purchased this track cutter when we started this job last year. We're out of South Louisiana, though. We work primarily in, I'd say, South, North, Central Louisiana, if that makes any sense at all. I'm sure to some of y'all it doesn't. We shovel thin when it gets wet.
Probably move really far out from that ditch.
Fixing to rack the other loader up over there. It's such a pretty day again. A little cloudy today. It's definitely summertime now, though, and it's hot. So,
Like I said, with this video here, most especially this video and a couple other videos, y'all are gonna see the color changing, maybe. Look at that. Look at that. Loader operator done got on the phone. Holding up productivity. Ah, I did give him hell. Don't take me serious, guys. Anyway. Still I find color setting. Everything like that that I want for the videos, you know, there's gonna be some changing back and forth with settings. And y'all may see some settings changes. But I don't know what looks good until I'm doing it. And a lot of times I don't have time just to sit here and play with a camera until I pick it up and start using it. Like right now, you know, look, see all the definition in the clouds that we got with that setting. But on my screen, it makes the loader look kind of dark. Kind of brighten the loader back up a little bit, and then we lose sight of our clouds, which sucks, but I guess we're not here to look at clouds, are we? Anyway. I've got to kind of get out of the way here. They're fixing to move the other loader over here. We'll be back after a while. Maybe. Should be. It's 2 o'clock. We should have one more truck to load for sure. And hopefully get a couple out for in the morning.
Back in a while.